In my first episode, I said that some of my videos would be tutorials. I think it's time. My name is Chris, and I'm a filmmaker. And sometimes, computers cause problems. In my last video, I had a problem. So, let's say your video is a deck of cards. A very big deck of cards, because it's 4K. When you play your video, you expect that the frames are going to play in the correct order. Well, let's just say that computer decided to get creative with your timeline. You make a video, you press play, and your frames go in the correct order, right? Well, I found this bug, and I've been able to reliably reproduce it, and it's a little like this. You see, it takes frames from elsewhere in the video, not too far down, and it puts them in the wrong place. I don't know how else to describe it. If you're actually playing the video, it might look like a jumping or a skipping. Since I shoot on the Panasonic GH5, I'm usually shooting in 10-bit. But when I'm shooting high frame rate, I have to shoot in 8-bit, and so I run into this bug. If I time reverse the footage, I'm even more likely to run into this bug. I don't know what's causing it, but I do know how to fix it. So let's take a look. You can see that bouncing around, and that's definitely not what I'm going for. The clip has no effects on it, so I know it's not caused by any of the effects. The other issue is, this is not just playback, it also ends up in the rendered video. If it was just me talking and it happened, you probably wouldn't know because the frames are so close to each other that the difference is imperceptible. But when you have some motion like this, where it completely gets the order wrong, you can definitely see the problem. If you look at a couple things, I'm playing back at full resolution and I'm not dropping any frames. So it's not a playback issue. But since it happens when I render, I tried different render settings, tried playback settings. I found, if we go to the preferences here under media, right here, enable accelerated H.264 decoding. This makes a big difference when you're playing back H.264 video. It plays it back much more smoothly. But sometimes, it also causes problems. I figured out if I disable that accelerated decoding, this problem doesn't exist. It goes away. That's one solution. I don't like my rendering and playback to be slow. It takes about 2 to 4 times as long to render the video, and playback is definitely choppier if I disable this as well. That's one solution. Just disable it altogether. But then again, when I'm doing 4K footage or whatever, it makes it really hard to play back the footage and it just gets painful sometimes. So what I did is I tried all these different render settings, and unfortunately, that's the only way to get this to work. There is, however, one other thing that we can try. And if I just right click and replace with After Effects composition, then guess what? I will open up After Effects, and what is it doing? Oh, there it is. It's going. It's going. Ah. All right. Save my After Effects comp, and all right, there we go. Save, because for some reason it was unsaved even though I just created it. All right, back to Premiere Pro. And now what we have here is an After Effects composition. Watch this. Didn't change any settings, left the accelerated decoding on, and what happens? All right, so we're dropping some frames, but let's try this again. All right, so I'm using After Effects to render this. You'll notice I'm dropping some frames, but you'll also notice that even with the dropped frames, it's playing smoothly. So for whatever reason, the Premiere rendering engine doesn't know how to do this. The After Effects rendering engine says, I know exactly how to deal with this file. I've got this. So here we are. Now I can play it back. I'm not dropping any frames, and that skipping, that jittering is gone. It's not quite as responsive as if the clip was in Premiere alone, but just like that, I'm done. Problem solved and move on with life. Don't need to worry about the bug anymore. Because this is a hardware thing, I don't know if the bug is in Premiere and Media Encoder, because it happens in either one. I don't know if the bug is in my hardware drivers. I don't know if the bug is in my hardware itself. I've updated the drivers. It says I have the most current versions. This is the most recent version of Premiere as of the date of this video, which is version 12.1.1 build 10. So I just updated Premiere this afternoon. Adobe literally just released an update today or yesterday. So a couple of things. The CUDA and OpenCL are going to render video much faster in software. So if you look here, you can see the rendering times for each of these based on Media Encoder. I also tried exporting video directly from Premiere instead of going to Media Encoder first. Didn't seem to make a difference. To recap, one solution: disable hardware accelerated decoding. I don't like that idea because I don't like things getting slower. Other solution: turn it into an After Effects composition and use After Effects to render your file. I don't know why After Effects does a better job than Media Encoder, but there you go. So if you like this, if it was helpful, let me know. If you'd like more tutorials, then hit me up. If there's specific things you're struggling with or tips that you've learned and want to share, then let me know in the comments. We're all in this together, so hopefully we can help each other out. I am really tired. It is past my bedtime, and good night. My name is Chris, and I'm a filmmaker. And sometimes computers cause problems. Like shutting off when you're trying to record a video.